to my channel. My name is Emily and I'm so glad you decided to stop by this video today. If you're wondering why the getup, the makeup, the hair, all of this, it is because today's video we are going to be doing following a 1950s housewife cleaning schedule for a day. I'm also going to be doing a video soon about living like a 1950s vintage housewife for a day, or day in the life of a 1950s housewife. That is going to be coming up soon as well within the next few weeks. But today I wanted to do just a following a 1950s housewife schedule, cleaning schedule. So if you know anything about the 1950s was the time where most women stayed home, most women were housewives, and they would cook and clean and take care of their house, their family, all day long, pretty much. Women weren't really working at this point. So, but I've always been obsessed with the 1950s, especially when I was younger. My dog is actually named after Lucille Ball from I Love Lucy, because I was obsessed with I Love Lucy. I still am, but I mean, I was obsessed with I Love Lucy. In fact, that's why I bought this dress. I bought this dress a long time ago, and then I've got these vintage red shoes. And yeah, so I was obsessed with I Love Lucy. And so I've always been obsessed with the 1950s housewife lifestyle. So I found a cleaning schedule on Pinterest. I will link it down below if any of you guys want to check out the blog post that I found the schedule from. So I thought it would be really fun to follow this schedule for a day and to film it. The schedule looks like I'm gonna get a lot done. So we're going to follow the schedule. If you guys want to follow along with me, I guarantee you, you are going to get a lot done if you follow this cleaning schedule. But I'm really excited for this video. I'm excited for my next video where I do a day in the life of a 1950s housewife. I think this is gonna be really fun. The day in the life of a 1950s housewife was not my original idea. There's videos like that all over YouTube. But I don't think I've seen anybody do a 1950s cleaning schedule. They may have, I don't know. But anyhow, let's go ahead and get started with this. I apologize in advance if the lighting situation is not that great. It is very overcast and cloudy today, and it's gonna be like that all week, and I just needed to film this video. So if the lighting situation is a little bit wonky, please forgive me for that, but let's go ahead and start cleaning like a 1950s housewife. So I wanna show you guys my getup. I realize probably that a 1950s housewife might wear her hair up, but I don't like my hair up, not really, so I just left my hair down. I added these sparkly, kind of blingy earrings, and then this dress is like a very vintage style because it's kind of like an A-line, a full skirt type dress, like they would have worn in the 1950s. I cannot remember the website that I bought this dress from. If I can, I think it was called Sammy Dresses. I think it was Sammy Dresses, but they come from like overseas and it takes forever to get them, so I kind of quit ordering from them. But I ordered this like a long, long time ago. But yeah, it's just like an A-line style dress. It cinches at the waist. And then I am going to show you guys, I've got these shoes here that are their original vintage red shoes. So let's go ahead and get started. I just realized I should probably add an apron if I'm going to be cleaning like a 1950s housewife. So I'm going to add this little apron here to my look. So the first thing on the cleaning schedule I thought was very interesting, and that is to let your bed air out for at least an hour. This cuts down on allergens and the possibility of dust mites, because it doesn't trap all of that sweat and stuff from the night before in the covers. So I think I'm going to start doing this on a regular basis. Second thing is to go ahead and open your curtains, open your blinds, and open those windows. And of course, it does need to be a nice day to be able to do this, but I have found that the power of airing out your house can do so much for just the overall air quality of your house. It keeps it from being stuffy, and it also lets out any bad stuffy smells that might have been left from the night before or just in general. So this is something that I have been doing a lot this spring, but it was also on the 1950s housewife schedule. So the next thing that I did was go ahead and I'm supposed to do the breakfast dishes. We didn't really have breakfast dishes because my husband left really early this morning. But I did need to wash bottles that I had used the night before, put some dishes up that I had left drying. And I just used this time to do an overall tidy of the kitchen because I had left my kitchen in a little bit of a disarray the night before. So we put him in as retro as I could find. I don't really have any vintage clothes for him. I have one outfit that I'm saving for the next video, the day in the life of a 1950s housewife video. So I'm saving that one for that video. So I just put him in little suspenders. That's the cutest thing I could find as far as they looked kind of vintage, but like, why am I so dressed up? I usually just stay in my sleeper. Yes. Baby spit up. Such is the life of a new mom. So now the 1950s housewife cleaning schedule says to get a tidy basket and just go around the house, gather up things that don't belong in that room, and then just distribute them in the rooms as you go through the house, and then pick up any other items that need to be placed back in their proper place and put them in the basket and just follow the same procedure until everything is in its place. Now it is time to straighten up the living areas, pick up clutter, lightly dust, straighten the pillows, and water the plants. So I went ahead and just did a dusting slash cleaning of all the things in my living room before I went ahead and straightened up the pillows, cleaned my couch off, and watered all of my plants. If you're wondering what I'm cleaning my couch with, it is just one of my DIY all-purpose sprays. I will leave the link to the recipe down below, as well as an affiliate link for my Amber Glass spray bottles. Thank you. for this time to finally make the bed and just do a light tidy and dusting of the bedroom. I will admit it felt really weird to wait to make my bed because usually that is the first thing that I clean every day, but I do think it was very nice for my bed to be able to air out before I made it up. So I go ahead and make my bed, and then I did a light dusting and just the general tidying of the bedroom. Now it's time to do a light tidy at the bathroom. This would include replacing toilet paper, replacing soap and hand towels, things like that, and then just generally wiping down all of the surfaces. This is not a deep clean of the bathroom, just a basic clean. Okay, so we had to take a pause because I had to eat lunch, and then my mom called, and then the dog woke the baby up, and then I had to eat some coffee cake and drink some coffee to recharge. So we've had a little bit of a standstill in our filming here, but I had to look back to see where I was on the cleaning schedule. So I'm getting ready to go in the kitchen, and it says to, let me pull it up real quick. I'm sitting in front of my computer. Wipe down kitchen work surfaces, which I kind of already did because I didn't know that was a separate thing from tidying the kitchen from breakfast. But I guess I could re-wipe it, that, and plus clean out the fridge. Usually I have a designated day for this, which is Monday, but for some reason it did not get done Monday. So I'm going to be cleaning out the fridge. And also, I have affiliate links now, so if you are interested in my cleaning spray bottles, I get a lot of questions about this lip color, anything like that that you have a question about or you want a link for it, I will link as many things as possible in the description box. It being an affiliate link just means that if you click on my link, I will get a teeny tiny commission if you make a purchase off that product. So if you don't mind clicking on the affiliate links, if you see something that you want for yourself and you're going to buy it anyway, if you want to click on my affiliate link, that would be great. They'll all be in the description box. So before I lose my light and it gets too late, let's go ahead and get back to our scheduled cleaning. Or mop the floor in the kitchen, so I went ahead and swept. It didn't need to be mopped because I recently mopped it. And then I went ahead and started setting the table for dinner. After we ate, I went ahead and cleaned up the supper dishes, and then the list said to arrange the living room for the family's enjoyment. So I just turned on a lamp and tried to make the living room look cozy and comfortable.
Okay, y'all, so
I came outside to end the video because it is getting kind of dark inside, but I got pretty much everything done that was on the 1950s housewife cleaning routine. I got a lot done, let's just say that. I'm very tired because I cleaned literally all day. But the schedule wasn't necessarily a whole lot different from what I would do on a normal basis, except for the fact that they kind of packed everything into one day versus, you know, I wouldn't do, like for instance, I'm not gonna sweep and mop my floor every single day, or I'm not going to dust every single day. So there was a lot of things, car went by. There was a lot of things that were on the daily schedule that I wouldn't do daily necessarily, but my house is very clean right now. I got a lot of stuff done. My house is very clean right now, and it's a good way to get exercise, honestly, because I was moving and going all day long. I took one break, and that was when I stopped for lunch, and I talked to my mom on the phone, but pretty much I was going all day long, and I'm still kind of going because I still got to clean up the rest from supper before I go to church. But overall, I really liked following this cleaning routine. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And then make sure that you're subscribed, because like I said, I will be doing a video for a day in the life of a 1950s housewife. And I'm going to dress me and Kate up very old-fashioned, and we're going to have a 1950s day. So I'm really excited for that video. So make sure that you're subscribed so you'll be notified when that video drops. And just so you can be a part of my YouTube channel. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.